It's 9 o'clock and the start of another day at Dunstable Salvation Army. First job for centre manager Charmian Knightley is to make sure everything is ready for a meeting of the district foster carers, the first of four outside groups who have bookings at the centre today.
People are very aware that this is a church, but the building can't just be here empty all through the week, just waiting for practices and meetings on a Sunday. So the vision really was to open it up to the community.
In any given week, about 18 outside groups use the hall, and there's a similar number of Salvation Army-led activities.
Very normal.
We've just had a recent count, and we think something in the region of 1,400 people come into the centre each week. So for whatever reason they come in through the doors, really that presents us with an amazing opportunity and responsibility to share something of God's love with them in the hope that they'll want to come and seek and find something of that for themselves.
It's about building up relationships with people so that when the opportunity arises, we're there to listen and to pray with them, to welcome them to come to different things. It might be that someone comes into Weight Watchers, but they have got an elderly parent that does need to come to be visited and to come to our over 75s. There's so many opportunities that link together.
It's Wednesday evening. Time for Ray and Colleen to go to Sainsbury's. But they're not buying food for themselves. The store donates food from its cafe to the core soup kitchen, food that would otherwise have to be thrown away. The soup kitchen operates every Wednesday from 7 to 9, and it's much appreciated.
Would you like some gravy?
You come here now for about 18 months, every Wednesday, apart from when it closed at Christmas. Christmas Day, just before Christmas, dinner was here, was lovely. Perfect. Absolutely perfect.
Makes me sort of get out and meet people and things, and it's helped me quite a lot. It is a godsend.
Tonight is a good night. I'm not sure how many's in, probably about 15, 16, and it's anybody. You know, some of them can't manage money, some of them live rough, sofa surf with friends and things, and we're just here to help.
One of the regular volunteers is Chris O'Brien. But 3.5 years ago, Chris was one of the soup kitchen's very first customers. He was cold, he was hungry, and he was heavily in debt.
I was low, so low, I lost my job. I didn't want to talk to no one. I'm living in this caravan in a village. I miss my mum, I miss my family, I miss friends. I become reclusive, if you like. And I walked to the Salvation Army. And I sat outside on the wall. It must be months. I'm watching all these happy people turn and frown, and I'm thinking, that's me. I should be in there. You know, they're my family. I need to be with these normal people, you know, nice, loving people. So I walked over and I see the lovely face of Major Carroll. Big, beaming smile. Welcoming smile, which is all I wanted, you know. Yes, you went, you know, do you want a cup of tea?
And when Chris mentioned his money problems, his new friends at the Corps were able to point him in the right direction. Dunstable Salvation Army's debt advice service started 6 years ago and has a steady stream of clients. Chris used to be one of them. The debt advice team were able to work out a payment plan with Chris's creditors.
They got it down to a level that it was menial amount, and now the debt's nearly done. It's gone, the headache's gone. I'm free of debt and I made friends along the way.
We can't pay their debts for them, but what we're doing is we're providing a route out of their debt. We're giving people a hand up rather than a hand out. And isn't that what the Salvation Army is all about?
At Dunstable, they also welcome people who are looking for an opportunity to give something back to the community. people like James, who's turned up out of the blue offering his services as a driver.
How did you find out about us?
I was actually watching Tech Centre and they said about volunteering in your area.
It's not just about what we can give, what we can offer to other people, but it's helping them to recognise that they too have a part to play here. Because people come in, they're welcomed as they are, and then we seek to help them to find a place too within the service, and then hopefully that leads them on to find a place within the worship.
Chris is a case in point. As well as volunteering in the soup kitchen, he's thrown himself into the life of the Corps and is about to become a Salvation Army soldier.
For if the willingness is there, the gift is acceptable. I can enjoy life now. I can smile again. I've got my big family, you know, a big family of loads of people that sit in that army, and each one of them genuinely have my welfare, you know, in their head and think of me as a person. And I love it.
It all comes under the umbrella of the church, that we're open to people and we want to show God's love to them through a practical way.